I am Ashley Drews, Medical Director of Infection Prevention and Control and Hospital Epidemiologist here at Houston Methodist Hospital. I am here to answer common questions related to novel coronavirus, known as COVID-19. The symptoms of coronavirus are varied. The majority of persons with coronavirus have a very mild illness that is very similar and often indistinguishable from the common cold. The virus can progress and be more symptomatic with fever, cough, and shortness of breath. Persons who are at highest risk for this to happen are elderly and persons who have underlying lung disease. Coronavirus spreads from person to person. Whenever a person coughs or sneezes, droplets are generated that carry the virus. Another person can inhale these infected droplets and then acquire the infection. Yes, coronaviruses can live on surfaces. It is unclear at this time exactly how long this coronavirus can live on surfaces because it is new and still being researched. If it behaves similar to other coronaviruses, as we expect it will, it can live on surfaces anywhere from 2 hours to maybe up to 2 days. The most important technique to prevent the transmission of the novel coronavirus is hand hygiene. It is important to use either an alcohol-based hand sanitizer or wash your hands with soap and water frequently. Other techniques that can be used would include a cough etiquette, which includes using a Kleenex whenever you cough or sneeze, and then disposing of that, and then again sanitizing your hands. Other things that are important would be avoiding close contact with sick persons, avoiding large crowds, avoid touching your face, particularly your eyes, nose, or mouth, and attention to your own personal health, making sure that you're getting enough rest and hydration. Wearing a mask is helpful to prevent the transmission of coronavirus. However, it is not recommended for persons of normal health out in the general public to wear masks at this time. This is an evolving screening process because this epidemic is changing so quickly and we are acquiring new information related to the coronavirus on a daily basis. Currently, we are screening patients who have symptoms of the infection, patients who have had some exposure either to a person with coronavirus or somebody with travel to an area where the virus is transmitting and in epidemic levels, or to patients with a severe respiratory illness that is unexplained otherwise. Our recommendations are in keeping and in concert with the recommendations by CDC and may change in the future based on new information. Coronavirus can cause a viral pneumonia that can progress to severe respiratory failure, and generally death is related to severe respiratory failure. There is no specific treatment for coronavirus at this time. Treatment is supportive care, which includes IV fluid, for mild cases, things such as Tylenol and Motrin and other fever reducers. For more severe cases, patients may be admitted to the hospital, administered supplemental oxygen, ventilator support, and other measures. There is a lot of active research into specific therapy for coronavirus, and there may be other treatments in the future. Tamiflu is effective for influenza, but it is not effective for this coronavirus.